All right, here we go. We are doing a Chromatic Cube draft on MTG Arena. We're in the waiting period between sets, so this is like a fun, like kind of crazy cube, if I remember correctly. Ooh, I do like Oracle of the Alpha a lot. This card's like not very good, but it's a really, really fun card. You shuffle Power 9 into your deck. It's honestly like not that good because you're shuffling like 5 lands in your deck also, but it is a really fun card. What else we got here? We got some Planeswalkers. We got Mirari's Wake, Niv-Mizzet Perun. Niv-Mizzet is pretty cool. I might just take Oracle, it's just fun, honestly. This card's super, super fun. What's Chromatic Cube? It's just a cube on Arena. It's just like, it's a cube, it's kind of like, it's almost like Commander-y. It's like a lot of big splashy stuff. You get the idea. But yes, Tenure Brew is going to be on Thursday. Set reviews already up on YouTube. Check that one out, of course. First time hit that follow button if you're on YouTube, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. I'm taking Oracle of the Alpha. I just want to cast this card. This is a freshly brewed card if I ever saw one. So, oh, there's Soul Herder. All right, we're doing it. We're just going to blink the shit out of this thing. That's what we're doing. We're in. We're going to table this Temple of Enlightenment and maybe Sarah Paragon. And we're just going all in. We're doing it. Is the new Urza Meld card in this cube? What are you talking about? It's not Thursday yet. We're doing it. Doing it and doing it and doing it right. Oracle's in this cube, yep. We blinking. We doing the things. Lotus Cobra, Spirited Companion, Ghostly Pilferer. I think being Bant might be reasonable for blinky stuff. There's some pretty good blinky stuff. Or you could say like Companion, which is obviously good both of these cards either way. I think it's Lotus Cobra, though. Table one of these green-white lands. Yeah. Lotus Cobra's like much higher upside. Yeah, man. It's like Bant Blink. That's our plan. That's what we're doing. We're banting and we're blinking. Cubist Phantom. Yes. Arena's so Arena's economy would not allow for a cube draft to not be Phantom, you know? Oh boy. I am pooped. There's also a spot where the alchemy cards are really fun. Everyone bitches about alchemy. I think alchemy's a really bad format, but I think the digital only cards are really fun, and I love historic. I think the digital only cards fit perfectly into a cube also. What are we doing here? What's going on? Jesus. Come on, Chameleon. Let's go. Relentless as rats. I understand that reference. Current alchemy format's great. I mean, like, I'm just not interested in alchemy at all. You know, like, just like too many formats. Thursday's early access releases next Tuesday. I believe that is correct. So we'll have 10 new brews for early access this coming... Ooh, Skyclave. This coming Thursday. And then we have Bronze and Mythic will probably start next Tuesday. It might be Wednesday, though. Pull of the Mist Moon. So many words, you got to scroll. When ETBs exile, running opponent controls, on leaves the battlefield. When it was kicked, it's only permanent. You can run the battlefield. Sure. Is it Skyclave or Esper Sentinel? Probably Skyclave. I do love Esper Sentinel. But Skyclave does seem very good here, as well as being very good in general. So, yeah, it's Skyclave. Come on, folks. Let's go here. What is going on? Resto! Bingo! Maybe we'll table the Baron, Talarian Archmage, or the Clone Crafter. A lot of Rakdos stuff in here. Death might end up straight blue-white. No need to be green. But I think that the Lotus Cobra was a high upside pick. Is worth it. You know, you got to go for the high upside picks in your cube draft. We can live without a common 1-1 for 2 that draws a card. We'll find plenty of other good things to blink. Wish they used a good art for Resto, you know? It's funny, I really, really hate all the cosmetics. Like, I hate them. But I would, like, pay extra to have, like, the arts that I like. You know? If you want to get my money, Arena... That's how you gotta do it, alright? Also, I would pay money to remove the card styles from my account, having to uncard style my cutdowns and my expensive iterations every single time drives me freaking insane. Alright. God Eternal Oketra. Touch Spirit Realm. Deputy of Detention. We have Niambi, Beloved Protector. Defense 50 Flash when EZB shoots a non-legendary card in your graveyard that was put there this turn. Return to the battlefield and gains start spell. Really draw a card only once each turn. That's a kind of a cool card, honestly. So you can save a thing that dies, and then it comes back. Obviously, it re-triggers all the ETBs, and then if it gets targeted, you draw. Pretty cool card, honestly, but I feel like we're taking Deputy here. It's just a better card, I think. Kind of sucks. Yeah. Alright, so a little clunky so far. Yeah. Yeah, Restoration Angel art. Yeah, not good. Not good. Just, like, give me more control of my program, you know? Like, I would also pay extra if I'd have to see my opponent's card styles. Like, I think I'd be embarrassed to say how much money I would spend to be able to just turn off all the card styles in the client and then choose the arts that I want. That's all I gotta do, you know? Like, because I can't stand when your opponent's, like, 12 lands in play and they're, like, Ikoria Triomes, just all this stupid shit, and you can't figure out what lands they have. Alright. Well, this is pretty bad. There are no good cards here for our deck at all. Horn of this thingy is not very good here. I love the animations. There's a setting to disable card styles. It doesn't work. Let's take the land, I guess. Just to keep ourselves a little bit open. Nicol Bolas the Ravager. Sigurdian Evangel. It's actually a fine card. It's a good card, to blank too. So you can keep like making more copies of it. I like this here. Odawar is pretty good, but like I need a 2-drop pretty bad, so I'm in. Yeah, disable what animations? They haven't made an animation in 2 years. Like, alright, so it stands. We're here. We can see what wheels out of our opening pack now. If the this is like the longest draft it's ever happened. Like, what is Chameleon? What are you doing? Come on, help me out. Cathar Commando's fine. It's obviously not very exciting, but this card's too clunky and stupid, I think. What I encourage you to do is to take this downtime between packs. Go follow me on TikTok. Go follow me on Instagram. Follow me on ChristianMingle.com. I'm not kidding. If you're watching on YouTube, it's in the description. Watching on Twitch, it's in the chat. Go follow me on stuff, folks. I got a baby. I got bills to pay. All right? A baby who never freaking sleeps. He never sleeps. Ever. Might sleep for like 2 hours, maybe, if we're lucky. What do you want to table out of this pack? Because it wasn't Paragon. It was something else, I feel like. But sure. Paragon's fine here. So I didn't sleep until 8 weeks old. So we're like almost halfway there. Oh my god. I wanted something else to table. And then Paragon was like the backup plan, I think. What's up, really? Thanks for reset. Appreciate that. I gotta make the babies emote. That's what I gotta do. Bark, bark, bark. Baby was contributing to the stream literally within 2 minutes of being born. I give you Jim D, baby rage. That's him, like 2 minutes after being born. They cleaned him up and handed it to me. He was not happy. And I got to make that into a moat. I should have it in time. What's up, Bach? First time chatter. What's going on, my friend? It's a draft. It's like if I get those cards, cards are sweet, but sure, whatever. Jim D stink. Honestly, blue's pretty not open. I should take in the squee there. I don't know if I've looked into baby sleep schedules, but they're worth it. Talk to me about this. Talk to me. I'm ready to hear it. We're no longer a magic channel. We're now strictly a baby channel. We only discuss baby things here. Baby's name is Cassian. Cassian James. First son didn't sleep through the night until he was 1.5. Oh my god. Don't say that. Son 2 was sleeping through the night at 2 months in. Alright, that's a little better. Hey! We're tabling everything. Holy crap. This is now the MTG Dad Support Channel. Yep. Let me hear your baby thoughts. Help me, please. All right, we have Thassa Deep Dwelling, which is obviously like, oh yeah, Ephemerate and Blink in the same pack. Jesus. All right. Ephemerate's like the best card in the entire deck. Hopefully we'll table Thassa or Momentary Blink. Not that I love Thassa that much, but it's obviously fine. Wouldn't mind Mind Stone, honestly, either, but Ephemerate's like the best card for us, so we're doing it. I don't cube too often on Arena, but I have cubed a few times, and the Blink deck has always been pretty good, so... Well, baby's almost 10 pounds, so... Not Caspian, Cassian. Cassian. I mean, none of these cards are really good for us, honestly. This card's just, like, good in general. Sure, I might not play it, but... Yes, like the Star Wars show. That was not intentional, but we weren't going to not name our kid, but we wanted to name our kid because of the Star Wars show. We haven't watched it yet, either. I've heard it's really good, but... Nightclub Bouncer. Oh, this card's sick, right? Full mana for a 2/3 flash. When an ETB's turn target non-land permanent, an opponent controls his owner's hand. Oh, this card's so sick. We did draft the Blink deck once, and this card was absolutely broken. Big Zach Cassian fan? No, but John mentioned that. John's like, hey, there's a guy on the Oilers or whatever, or some other team that has a name. I would pay good money for 6 straight hours. Overseer's fine. We have tons of threes, and this card's actively really good, so... Adversary, Mimic, Other Mimic, Crowbar. I mean, Glasspool's like obviously pretty reasonable. Just like a land with upside. I do want to have more 2-drops and cheap spells if possible. Would I pay more for sleep or hiding opponent cosmetics? Here comes the money. Pay for it all. I'll bankrupt myself. Glasspool with Nami. Why is that so good? I'll take Glasspool. History. Wrong color pathway or nothing. Wow, all right. Blade Splicer's the nut. Maybe we'll table the Elite Guard Mage. Love me some Blade Splicers. A lot of threes right now, you know? So we have a couple... We have 4 2-drops. And a lot of our threes catch up also. Boom, 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 boom. It's obviously Chameleon's first draft. It's fine. Everyone's first cube draft is always very, very intimidating. It's a lot taken at once, so I don't begrudge them, but oh my god. Chameleon, what are you doing to us? All right, we have the Vile Duplication. This card doesn't belong in the cube. Should I take a Baneslayer for the sideboard? Oh, it's best to one, actually. Let's take Baneslayer. I'm not going to play it, but sure. Micromancer? Oh yeah, give me Micromancer. That card better be in this cube. It's a fun build around. Micromancer, Ephemerate, Oracle. You could go get your Ancestral Recall over and over again. What happened with Baby Day? So talk about the schedule more. I want to hear more about the schedule. What do you mean schedule? What are you talking about? How do you schedule a baby? Do you say, okay, baby, the schedule says sleep now. You gotta do what the schedule says, just how it works, right?
You look terrible.
I know. Months of training. Set a bedtime and stick to it, make a routine. But he doesn't go to sleep. He just lays there and cries. what's the... WonderBaby.com! Oh, let's go. New stream sponsor, WonderBaby.com. All right, we got Catacomb, Endgame, to Catacomb. We have a few black lands now, so like we end up in Esper somehow. It could be cool, but it's probably not gonna happen. You reason with them. Ah, yes. You reason with the baby.
Wow.
But how do you make baby go to sleep? Baby won't go to sleep. That's the problem. They just lay there and cry and cry and cry. What's up, Lobmancer? Somebody get this baby a day planner. Let's go. Oh, yeah. Whoops. Whiskey or vodka. There you go. Feed them more. He eats till he pukes. Like, he just eats. He'll keep eating and eating and eating and eating. And the goal is to be careful not to overfeed him, so he'll just spit up. I just gotta cry. Boom, boom, boom. The baby needs a personal assistant. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Me too. Oh, chameleon. Chameleon, chameleon.
I'm going to clone college.
Come on, chameleon. You can do it. We're going this way. Oh, the packs are so far from us. Here comes one. Here comes a pack. Here comes a pack. Cast charm sleep in the baby. How's personal assistant thing going? I haven't had time to hire anybody yet. Which sucks. It's funny. I haven't had time. So I ruined you an assistant, but I haven't had time to like actually hire an assistant. Life's tough, folks. All these cards suck. What's this card do? This card's actually pretty cool, but yeah, whatever. Sure. Lactation consultant? Not yet. I mean, like, it's just like you just don't feed him as much, you know? Like, if they weren't connected, they would be disconnected by now, just like auto picking, right? Who knows? Wyatt Darby's final stream was of Q. Final stream for what? Is he not streaming anymore? You could spend channel points to buy a spot in the queue to make a pick. I mean, that's a pretty fun thing to do. Sun wouldn't eat unless he was in a burrito. Like the swaddle thing. All right, we're like, it's weird. Like, our deck seems very open, but also not open at the same time. Which is like fine. We have plenty of playables. Auto picks the way through the timer. So if you time out and just like disconnect, it'll time you out every pick for the entire draft. That's so weird. C. Snid says, I also eat until I puke and then cry, so it might be a fun character trait. Yep, yep, yep.
Make a little noise here, huh?
Come on, I can't hear you!
Do, 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 do. All right. Rat-a-bat-a-bat-a-batic. And, all right, so we got 16 playables, a little more than that, honestly. We got Rafine's Tower, Fable Passage, Sublime Epiphany. And I said, what about March of Otherworldly Light? Nothing here is great. I don't want to land, honestly. We actually have zero lands right now. Let's take Rafine's Tower. Epiphany is obviously very good, but like we're not very flashy at all. So, yeah, this is a very, like, dirtily cube for sure. There aren't really any aggro decks, so, like, it is kind of just, like, it's kind of like Commander. It's, like, big mana mishmash decks just, like, mashing their heads to each other. All right, so Immortal Sun, Welcoming Vampire, Cut Down. Immortal Sun's actually kind of gas. This card is really good. We have zero Planeswalkers at present, and it is a very powerful card. Welcoming Vampire is also pretty sweet. There's a lot of removal spell in this format. I already have a decent amount of threes. I think Immortal Sun's a little too clunky. Just like six mana in our deck with no ramp. Just take Vampire. Cavalier of Dawn, Charming Prince, Vizier, a bunch of lands. I don't like Prince that much. Prince is good in blink decks. Like, Prince, in order for Prince to be good, it needs to have some sort of a purpose in your deck, not just, like, maybe Scry or whatever. And in a blank deck, it does have that, so. So we're currently at 18 playables. Lisa splashable, not worth it. Like, I don't even want to play Baneslayer here, so. Got Momentary Blink, Ephemerate, so many cards. Cards. Oh my god, I'm invisible!
Waka waka!
Oh. Restoration of a Ganjo. Ooh. Oshi the Exquisite Blade. Alright, best card from draft. It is a blanky card, right? Every cast second spell, you blank something. Is that good? I don't know if it's, like, actually good. Yes, Charming Prince is a pun. Yes, it's easy to miss. But he is a charm on a creature. Restoration is... It's fine. Yeah, man, sure, I'll try it. Just take the blank card every time. 19 playables. One land. Is the blue-white theme in Arena Cube always blink? Oh, it's always, but it is fairly often blink, yes. Lion Sash, Expertise, Dream Eater, Leer, the Celestis. I mean, Baral's is, like, not bad. You can also bounce your own shit and recast it, which is kind of cool. It's honestly better than it looks. I don't think I want Celestis or Lion Sash, so... Dream Eater's just, like, heinously expensive and clunky. Ooh, boy. We got the Dawn Sky. We got Emil the Blessed. This is a 4-4 for 4 that blinks your stuff. Sure. I mean, we already have, like, a lot of 4-drops, honestly. But there's nothing else here I really want. Like, the Dragon's okay, but... Yeah, just Blessed it. Sure. I feel like I'd add that Mind Stone. I don't really like that Mind Stone. Would like a little ramp in this deck, honestly. We're a little lacking in that regard. Our deck is a little clunky, but... Yeah, I would like to not play this. So we have a 5-drop. We have 5 4-drops. That's so many 4-drops. These blue green lands, spark double. I don't have that card in my deck. Let's take a blue green land in case things get weird. I don't know. We obviously have plenty of playables. It's like we can just play Crowbar and Lyra or Intervention are all playable cards in our deck. And that's 23. So it's like we're like dying for playables. So even I'm freaking blinking. I look at my blanket. Ready? Whip. Blank. Whoop. Blank. Block. Blank. Block. Sanctuary Warden. That card is good. It's a good card. I like that card a lot. What's going on? Where's he going? No solitude. No solitudes here now. No solitudes here. The March Tabled? I'm cool with that. I like March in this deck. Limousine is whatever. I'm not going to play that. I might even play 18 lands in this deck, honestly. We're like just so mana hungry. It was so much to do with our mana. Cavalier of Thawn is... Thawn is kind of lame. Vizier... Honestly, Vizier isn't terrible, but... This card's fine. All right, cool. Restoration's fine. It's like sort of like a land, right? So I think we're good. This is our deck. So we got 23 cards. We got that one. We have one Rafine's Tower. It's our only non-basic. Cavalier is just clunky. I already have a 5 drop. I already have a 6 drop. Like, if our deck gets going, we're going to crush anybody. But the problem I'm worried about is not getting going. So any clunky card is like a pretty high bar, I think. Like, Warden's really good. And it goes kind of cool also. But Lion Sash? Whatever. Oh, Glass Pool's a land also. Oh, perfect. So we're going to play 18 lands. One of them being Glass Pool. That's perfect, I think. We want to make every single land drop. And yes, if you blink when the saga flips, if you blink it, it's back to being a saga again. All right, so... Oh, these lands are ugly as sin. Ugly as sin. Where are my lands at? Oops. That one's okay, but... I'm going to do 9... Do 9-7. Not the best mana base in the world for a cube draft, but... We have some double whites, a lot of white early. And... I think that's just it, folks. I think it's our deck. Do y'all want to do a prediction? Should we do a prediction here? See if we can get the wins or not? What's your prediction? 7 wins, yay or nay. What do you think, folks? It's prediction time. Place your bets on YouTube. Take a second, pause the video, scroll to the comments, and leave a comment saying yay or nay, believer or non-believer. Stream, folks, there it is. Place your bets, 7 wins, yes or no. Cube draft. Let's do this. Brought to you by...
Cool Stuff Inc. is proud to sponsor Jim Davis. We offer great deals on card games, tabletop RPGs, board games, and more. Get a free token featuring Jim Davis and take 5% off your next order if you use the code JIM5 at checkout. CoolStuffInc.com. Cool stuff in stock.
Oh, here we go. Ooh, we got a mixture here. We got believers and non-believers. What's it going to be, folks? Nice in my opening hand. Have you changed your mind at all? Their deck's pretty good, honestly. I would pick Believer, personally. I'm going to keep this. Oh, shit. Jim plays golf? I do, but how do you know that? It's on the card, right? Yeah, I do. Chat, coming out of me. All right, let's go. Golf stream when? I would stream some golf, honestly. That could be like a good donation bonus or some sort of like bonus or something. I owe you all a streamed... What are they at, my Paragon? I owe y'all a streamed hockey game, but I haven't played hockey in a long time, so. All right, so we're gonna just scry 2 here, I think. Honestly, we're curving out really well over the next few turns. We could just like gain 3 if we're like scared of dying. Yeah, scry 2. Oh, I love Nightclub Bouncer, let's go. All right, so we have probably Vampire next turn, be a little greedy. Oh yeah, they steal this. I screwed up. Still a piece of garbage. They didn't attack! Bingo. Can you believe that? They didn't attack? So sick. Alright, what does this card do? Forgeborn Phoenix. He can't keep getting away with it. 2-2 Flyer. Whenever it dies, pressure gains an equipped creature. You control its combat damage to a player. Finds a discarded grave. Sure. Alright, Vampires, it goes. Literally never punished. Literally. Actually, factually. Yeah, I saw CGB at Worlds. I let him know about the karaoke thing. He was like, whoa, 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 you did not include me in this discussion. I told chat, I have a video of me, Nicole, Lady Lavinius, and CGB doing Men in Black karaoke at too many games very, very late. And it's heinously bad. It's so bad. And I said if I won Worlds, I'd put the video up. And I came in 5th. It was close. So Nightclub Bouncer is going to bounce the Manaform Hellkite. I'm just going to do it now because I don't want to get a token. So let's cast this. Now this costs 5 mana. And the more I blink it, the more I get to do... Oh my god. Oh, we drew Ephemerate. Oh yeah. Let's go. All right, so we get to go... Here's Hellkite. So we get to go... I'll draw land here. I did not draw land. Look who it is.
I can't tell you if the cat's on the street. The problem is, it is not. Don't grab it.
It is not. Look who's here. Everybody say hi. OK. God damn it. What did you do to this thing? It's a booby trap.
Yeah.
It's a baby trap. Hi, baby. I gotta play with her in a second. We're gonna just tap land OG, whatever. Hi, baby. Come here. How you doing, baby? What's up, son? Ooh. Did he fart?
Was that him?
He loves farting.
That was him.
He loves farting and shooting his pants. It's his favorite thing to do. Hi, kid. March of Other Royal, take that one. Take the land, too. How you doing, kid? Hmm?
Apparently he's ready to poop his pants.
Oh, he's waving. He does love pooping his pants. Hey, pooping your pants is cool. Call me Miles Davis. Okay, Miles. Okay, Miles. Here he is. The boy who never sleeps. Lelia the Blade Reforged. That card's pretty good, baby. That card's pretty good. They're going to reconfigure onto Lelia and attack with a flying 3-3. It's kind of sick. This is like the rare aggro deck in this cube. It's like no aggro decks at all, usually. All right, so we're going to... we're going to march this thing and then cast a spell and then blink my bouncer. That's sick, actually. Baby, this is so good. Baby, hit the button. Hit the button, baby. He did it. Look at him. He's ready to go. Exile Lelia. Don't spell pierce me, please. And then we're gonna blink the bouncer, right? So we go land companion. And then we're gonna blink the nightclub bouncer. What do you think, baby? What do you think, dude? Is our deck good? Cassie, get over here. Look at the camera. Ready? Ready? This way. Yeah, we'll go like that, alright? Is that good? Nope, he's going that way. He's getting a little stronger. He's able to hold his head up a little more now. Up, kinda. Sorta. I got you. And we'll say go. And now we're just doing it. We're doing it, Cassian. We're doing it, bud. Everyone say hi to baby. Ah, 6 mana, Manaform Hellkite. What do you say we just keep bouncing this thing every turn? Forever. That's what I want to do. We're going to Blade Splicer Restoration. Love it. Blade Splicer. Love it. Restoration. Draw a card. Oh, we're just popping off. We are popping off right now. Blink this thing. Told you this card was the nut. How about 7 mana for the Hellkite? What do you think, baby? 7 mana? Get a Plains. Play a Plains. Am I boring you? Am I boring you? I'm boring him. All right, jeez. It's like an average Twitch view.
Well, he's
okay, bye, baby.
Sure, that was Ben.
Sure. All right, it was me. I shit my pants. It wasn't baby. I'm just blaming baby. All right, hand's great. Their deck is quite good. Also like daddy, he craps on stream, yep. Cradle cam in the future? Nah. I'll exploit Kara. I'm not going to exploit baby, you know? So get a Magda. I mean, it's funny. I don't want to trade, really, because I'm going to blink it. I can blink other stuff, too, though. So, what's up, 2000? It's a shit in my pants stream, huh? Dragon Master. Why is everyone trying to play aggro decks in this cube? It's like the worst cube for aggro decks. Marvel Snap's fun. I've been playing a little bit on my phone. I downloaded it for, I downloaded it on my flight home from Vegas. I've played a decent amount. Who's playing Marvel Snap? Let me know in chat. If you're a snapper, put a little snap finger thing in chat. I don't like the card, availability. Like, I've been playing, I'm like level 40-ish. I kind of hit the wall on level 40. Oh, man. And I just see all these really cool cards that I want to have, and I just don't have them, and it's kind of like, all right, I guess, like... And there, what is going on? I was talking about how bad aggro is in this cube. People are trying to prove me wrong. All right, well... We can just, like, double Evangel here, honestly. Just, like, 2-3 ones is actually pretty good in this board. We do need to kill this before they get to 5 lands in play. Sure. The thing is that, like, you could say Fun Police, but, like, I don't think this deck's very good in this cube. Like, they're kind of doing it, but I'm still at 15, you know? All right, so conjuring up Cigardians. This card's like actively very good. This card cost me top four in the Kamigawa Neon Dynasty Championship. Cycle Triome? Interesting. Alright. So we got Sarah Paragon. We got Soul Herder. We have an attack. Very aggressive. We can deputy this outcast. Now they have the brute. The brute's super awkward. Because then they can hit my deputy. Well, I guess this doesn't actually matter because I can just like blink deputy every turn and kill all their dragons or whatever they get. It's dragons, right? Yeah. So let's do this and say go. My butt is on YouTube. Go watch it on YouTube. Alright, that's a huge problem, honestly. And they're gonna attack. I gotta like block and just blink and eat the tokens. This is the beginning of your upkeep, it makes the dragons. So I have Soul Herder also. Yeah, I'll do that. Is Snap mobile only? I think there's a PC client. You know, obviously Hologlyph's been streaming it a lot. And good for Jeff too. I think it's really awesome that Jeff like got it on it super early and now he's like the biggest Snap streamer. He's doing really, really well. Makes me very happy to see people succeed. Oh, they have two mana. Oh, I'm so stupid. Whatever. It's on Steam. Is it like horizontal on the computer or? Yeah, I screwed up. I didn't realize they had two mana up. All right, so they're gonna kill my 3/1. Yeah, that's kind of a tilt. Yeah, I screwed up pretty bad there. That's okay. Baral's Expertise. That card's kind of gas. We can man, what do we do now? Jeez. We could Paragon and Companion. That would make it day, though, so Brutal Cathar goes off, which is, like, super awkward. It's not even that good, either. I'll just play Paragon, I guess. Play Paragon, play Companion, draw a card. Alright, so they go. Yeah, now they eat something, but I can just, like, get it back anyway, so it's fine. That's a challenging game. Jaya, Fiery Negotiator. Every creature your opponent controls. Wow, they're gonna kill my deputy here. This sucks. That's really bad for us. Shit. Yeah, we're in big trouble now. All right, we'll just take this. March of Otherworldly Light. Okay. So we can like march. This for one, and then Expertise. That's not bad either. That was pretty good, actually. All right, so let's march for one. Hit this. Submit zero. Exile this. We tickle Jaya. And then we Brawl's Expertise, bouncing Goblin Cathar. And then we just cast the Paragon again. I'm sorry. I mean, we cast Soul Herder. That's pretty good. Alright, so play Soul Herder. You blank this. I told you Brawl's expertise is sweet. It's the only way this deck loses is if we, like, fall behind. So with expertise, you just never fall behind. You just, like, go nuts. I think that was a good turn, personally.
Just when I thought I was out.
I think that was a good turn. Brogthar's back, sure.
Go on, impress me.
Shit, sorry. Hit this, and then this comes back, and then we just, like, I don't even know. We could, like, double Sigardian here. It's kind of cute, too. Sure, let's do that. Sigardian, tap this thing. Conjure Sigardian. Sigardian. Tap Jaya. Lord Star Resup, thanks so much. Attack Jaya. Really, Ryan says, got 7-0 with a stupid Gruul Stompy. Minx can boo or stars of a show. Got some late mana dorks. Had to go in. Awesome, my friend. Tapping Jaya is a power play. Tasted, old lady. Power Gun's really good in this deck. Say, this game's looking pretty good. Yeah, so as I was saying earlier, don't draft Aggro Miscube. Unless you're really, really bold. Exile top two. They have a Atsushi and a Lightning Bolt. Alright, they're gonna play a dragon? Sure. I wonder how I'll deal with that. Alright, let's, do we just a guardian again for, like, maybe make a million 3/1s? Or do we, we can just do the hell we want, honestly, right? Like, so many options. This is... This blinks things all... Sure. Do this. Just do this. Target this. Pay a mana. Get a counter. Attack with everything. Game seems pretty open... pretty over, honestly. Like... I guess if they, like... If they spike a Wrath here... I guess if they have, like, a Wrath effect, they get back Dragon and Brugathar. Probably lose that game, but, like, if they're playing a Wrath in their aggro deck, like, whatever, you got me, you know? I'll take the L. I'm not afraid to lose. Robber the Rich. Look, Ma, no cards. Alright, they get back a 3-3, whatever, not Brugathar. The point is they get a board. Sweet. Imagine being a non-believer. Come on. We're going to 7 up so easily. Like. Sure. Keep. Whoa! Lutri in cube? That's just not fair. It's just a free companion. Sure. Alright. Ephemerate. We're going to Cathar Commando, I think. We could always dog Ephemerate next turn. Commando, some Guardian, sure, attack, and yeah, we'll just Companion here, try to draw land. One Lando, please. Works for me. For some of this ends battlefield, choose an art launcher, creature, your graveyard, or those put there in the battlefield this turn. Pushing up by Lutri. Sure. We're just giving the beatdowns right now, right? Yeah, whatever. Would I trade my left nut for lifetime unlimited sushi? I don't even like sushi. Like, so no, to answer your question. Bizarre question. All right, well, now I have 10 power on the board and they're at 13. So I don't even like my left nut. Yeah, exactly. They got Lutri. We got a stacked hand. And they have Rashimi Eternity's Crafter. That's not going to live. We're just going to march this. We'll just exile, like, something. I don't know. Prince, maybe. Exile. Maybe it's this thing. Our shit's, like, never going to die. Yeah, whatever, sure. Exile this. Attack for Virgilian. You're just dead. So there you go. Card's really good. Like. Alright, I mean, easy game.
After it was all over, he took us in the house to serve his pancake.
Not sushi, though. I'm a quesadilla guy. Quesadilla, quesadilla. Quesadilla, quesadilla. Quesadilla, quesadilla. Ooh, quesadilla. And then you say... Alright, we'll just play a 3-1. Tar pizza. Tar pizza's good, too. Tap that land. Man, I want Aether Vial on Arena for this card so bad. Give me my Aether Vial, please. Alright, so attack for 3. If you just say go, we're not playing anything here. Just play tap land, so go. Yeah, bins it for the Paragon, too. Yeah, this card's super sweet. Very fun design. Banting. Elite Spellbinder. Sure. You got me. Spellbind away. Goblins are already too strong in Historic? They're not. Goblins are good in Historic. They're not, like, too strong. And Aether Vial, like, is weird in the Goblin deck. Because, like, it's like a Muxus deck, kind of. It'll be very good, obviously, but... Yeah, Aether Vial not being in the retro thing is a big tilt, for sure. It's like super easy spot to put it. Do love me some Aether Vial. Pick a card, any card. They took our Ephemerate, sure. Cathar Commando. Problem is I would like pretty happily trade, but then I just have like nothing to do really. Looks like I could just like Skyclave it, I guess. Oh, Tanglewire. Tanglewire would have made me the happiest man on earth. People didn't realize how good Aether Vial was for a long time, Wicked. That card didn't see play. Like, that's a card you would proxy on when it first came out. Aether Vial didn't see play for a while. It saw a little play in Affinity, but like pretty narrow. And then they just deputied my Skyclave. What a dick. Alright. I guess we like... Can just like deputy the 3-3 and attack, I guess. And the question is, do I want to play a land or hold this? I'm going to play as a land. Just attack. Just attack. They're not going to block. I'll play this as a land, so I go. I think having a lot of mana is very important, so. We have a blink, too. Yeah, it's fun. I can deputy their deputy, but, like, then I get back a Skyclave, and then what happens, you know? Doesn't do anything, so. And the thing is, like, playing a creature like this in a blink deck on a token is so good. What is this, a freaking... I don't know, I got nothing. Alright, so here's Skyclave. We got a true mirror here. I can march their deputy and Skyclave or Skyclave, get like a 3-3. Sure, I'm in. Alright, submit 0. Exile this. And then we'll hit this. And then we'll attack for 3. Get a 3-3. They're at 8, and I have a commando in hand also, so I have 11 power on the board. Obviously, playing in pod is much more fun in cubes, so you're not playing mirrors. But the reality is that, like, playing in pod is, like, the worst thing ever online, so... I do agree that, you know, playing in leagues or whatever online does damage the sanctity of the cube draft format a little bit, but it, the upside is so worth the downside. It's just a freaking 2-1, sure. Just a freaking 2-1. 11, 3, 6, 7, 8. I mean, I can blink my Cigardian, tap this, and just make two more Cigardians. I kind of like that, actually. Three, two, two. Yeah, man. Attack for a billion. Just like, don't wrath me, you know? Play as a guardian. Yeah, like, when Magic Online introduced leagues, because for a long time, Magic Online was all pod-based play. You play an eight-player standard tournament, you play an eight-player drafts, you play a four-round premier event or whatever. When they introduced leagues, after a month, it was like, holy shit, how did we ever do anything else than this? Like, they're at three? We're good, they're dead. Okay. Very, very close to stabilizing here. We still haven't, we haven't dead on board. All right, and give me the old... The old Leroy. Yeah, like, when I used to play on Magic Online, I've been playing Magic for a bajillion years, so I'm so old, but I used to play back in, like, 2003 or whatever, and my clan name was a one-person clan, and it was, I play Nintendo between rounds, because there was so much downtime between rounds, and I would, like, just have my NES out, and I would just be playing. Deck's busted. Just too good. Do I just cast this as a 2-2? I don't know. Probably not. Maybe. I don't know. Oh boy. Everyone pumped for Brothers War? Is everyone pumped, excited for 10 new brews on Thursday? And excited for Bronze Mythic on Tuesday? Who's pumped? And who's going to, SG Philly? I asked that already, but I didn't see any answers. Have we even drawn our Power 9 card yet? The hell? What is going on? What? You missed it. I did. We did the Mystical Archives for Brothers War, like the ninth section of a set review, at the start of a stream. That'll go up on YouTube a little later today. That is the 63 cards that are in the set, and legal in draft and historic that are old border reprints. All right, this is a pretty easy march here. I should Skyclave. Nah, I should Vampire. Let's march and Vampire. All right, give me the old welcoming Vampire. Welcome. I'm fading away. Oh, I'm gonna bounce my Vampire, huh? It's kind of a dick move. Let's play it again, I guess. Don't kill my Vampire. God. Bastard. The price of fame. To us, the cast and a legend. Reacher Surveil 2. Huh. Interesting. Alright. Milling over a Forsworn Paladin. And we draw a land. All right, I guess we just like Skyclave. We have the Nimbian, this thing to protect this, I guess. Sure, I don't love it, but. Nothing. All right, attack. Four cards in hand, huh? Okay. I mean, this sucks a little bit, but... So... They block. I can save my Skyclave, but... It doesn't really do anything, because... it's just going to be a 2-2, and if they target it, I draw a card, but they're never going to target it, obviously. I guess I save it, though, and I can, like, blink it and stuff. Yeah, I'll save it, I guess. Oh, shit, I misread the card.
That's it. I'm going to clone, Whatever.
All right, I screwed up. First time casting a card, of course I screwed it up. No problem. It has to be cast when the creature's already in the battlefield. Easy 7-0? Yeah, I'm still going to 7-0. No problem. Play bad, win anyway. It's the whole point of a stream, folks. It's how we do things here. All right, here come the tokens. I have Baral's Expertise and Deputy in my hand for tokens, which is great. Spider Queen. All right. Travel says, binge your content during my leave. First time catch me live. What's up, Steve? What's here for Steve? First time chatter. How's it going, Steve? No discards here. Orlando. This is a, that was actually an insane draw too. We're gonna go 1, 2, 3. And then we're gonna let's cast Deputy too, I think, right? Cast Deputy. Kill this. Kill this. Oh yeah. Woo! Love it! Omizawa. Whenever you activate a ninja ability, look at the top of the cards of your library. Each creature in your hand is ninja. Swarm Saboteur. Oh, what a draw! Woo! Seraph Paragon. Get back Skyclave. Whenever it deals combat damage to a player, conjure a Virus Beetle. Okay. I'm playing Marvel Snap. Yeah, it's pretty fun. I get Vampire first. Honestly, Vampire and Architect's pretty sweet, too. Just, like, block this thing. Yeah, whatever. Just play Vampire. Sick value. Ninja Vanish is not on the soundboard anymore. Unfortunately, that was a Kamigawa Neon Dynasty specific soundboard item. Still a piece of garbage. Glass Pool Mimic. Copy the Swarm Saboteur. Alright, so I'm just gonna trade off here, which is like totally fine, right? Pretty happy with that. And now I got the Architect and the Vampire and the Paragon. We got everything going on. Nightclub Bouncer too. God, Nightclub Bouncer is the newt. Alright, I'm just gonna kill everything. I'm just gonna make them feel bad about their life, honestly. Let's hit this. Draw a card. You miss baby talk? Nah, we talk about babies. Baby never sleeps. Talk to me. How do I make baby sleep? I'm gonna hold this till their turn, honestly, so I can draw a vampire again. Yeah. Alright, so take a bunch. I guess there's no reason to bounce this. Yeah, we'll just say go. This card's nasty good. We still haven't drawn our Power 9 card, our first pick yet. This is like game 5.
Game. Blouses.
So easy. Where are we at right now? We get a game count here? Huh? We are currently 5-0. I want to remind you that 49% of y'all said we're gonna get 7 wins. I'm just casually bringing it up for no reason at all. I do want to remind y'all, we're also brought to you by Coalesce Apparel. Coalesceapparel.shop. Not all shirts are see-through. But this one isn't either. Check it out, Coalesceapparel.shop. They have a bunch of new designs now. Also, they have the new Infect shirt, the new Live Long and Prosper shirt. Which is cool. Check it out, Coalesce Parallel Shop. Promo code GM 10% off your order. The Coalesce booth was bumping at Magic 30. It was awesome. So obviously Cedric doing well. And check it out, Coalesce Apparel.shop. Promo code GM 10% off your order. Coalesce Apparel.shop. Stickers and hoodies too. Sweet. Sweet. Alright, Soul Order, Vampire, Emil the Blessed. Okay. One day we'll draw our Power 9 card. Fable, Norn, Epiphany, Junland, Prosper. What's your pick in this cube? Whatever you want. The beauty of cube drafting is you can defend almost any first pick. You know? You just want to do your thing. I do want to draw the card I first picked in this draft. That'd be really cool, but 5-0. Guardian Idol. Welcoming Vampire. I got Emile the Blessed. Whatever thing is winning. Oh my god, they're going huge. This is, they have Ugin or something like that? That would suck. We can't beat Ugin. Ugin's insane against us. I mean, I want to draw a card, but I'm going to kind of play this 4-4, I guess. It ain't worth winning if you can't win big. Ugin's unbeatable. Yeah, we can never beat an Ugin in a million years. We have literally no way to beat it, so. Don't Ugin me, bruh. It would make sense that Ugin was not in this cube, because Ugin's so good against random bullshit. This is kind of like the random bullshit cube, so. We draw this card every game, yeah. Can't draw our first pick, though. There it is. Oracle of the Alpha. Just can't draw it. Legendary Horse. It's like Shadowfax. This is the legends you can talk. Like, Shadowfax is the legendary steed of Gandalf the Grey, you know? It's a unicorn, too, technically. Wow, this is not the big turn I think they were hoping for. Like, turn 2, ramp. Turn 3, ramp. Turn 4, I have 7 mana. I play Kallus Blood Mage and Ornithopter of Paradise. What are you doing? Alright, I kind of want to bounce some shit, honestly. Just bounce some shit and play Seraph Power God or Soul Herder. I'm going to hold the Seraph Power God. Let's bounce, like, Mana Rock, mana thing. And let's put in the, I'm going to put in Soul Herder, I think. We'll draw off the Vampire. Because if I put in Power God and they, like, Wrath or something like that, it's pretty bad for us. I want to be able to use the Power God's ability, so. Play this, draw a card. We did it! Bingo. Might not matter, but we did it. They're just jump blocking. Alright. Is Damnation in this cube? We'll blink the whatever. This thing, sure. Doesn't matter. Opponent's decks have seemed kinda bad. Yeah, I mean that's the thing though, just like, you know. There's no ranking in cubes. You just play against anyone. So folks are like, oh, cool, you know, and that's great. You know, it's like, just because your opponents aren't your, you know, higher level diamond and mythic players doesn't mean they're not good people, you know? Yeah, it looks like we're just going to, like, win the game before it even matters, but I'm trying, folks. I want to do my cool stuff. I'm casting Oracle next turn no matter what. Even if I draw a land, I'm not playing I'm Warden. We're just playing Oracle. I want to draw one piece of power of this draft, if possible. All right, there it is. It's all back in play. All right, I'll cast the Restoration too, though. Restoration, get a Plains, play Oracle. Conjure in that Power 9. Oh, we did it! Mox Jet, we did it. Do it again. We're just adding a bunch of lands to our deck, but whatever, who cares? This is fun. I want to do the things. I came here to do the things. It's fun streaming again. I love competitive Magic. I love playing serious events. Worlds is very stressful. And the time leading up to Worlds is also pretty stressful. And it took me, like, honestly, like, maybe 5 hours to get back into the flow of, like, streaming. Again, because I was just, like, in serious kind of, like, tournament mode. Feels good. I like it. They're never going to deck us. That's true. They're never going to mill us out. Our deck now has 43 cards in it. Look at that deck. Thanks, Moof. Appreciate it. And again, if you missed it, I came 5th place at Worlds. I won $20,000. And my article on CoolStuffInc.com goes over the entire event. Go read it. We went 17-3. Oh, yeah, my video's up today, too, actually. Definitely go. This is the one you got to watch. My team went 17-3 in Explorer in non-mirror matches at Worlds. That's a fucking dominating performance, all right? I'll use my F-bomb. Dominating performance. And you can watch the video about it and go check it out. CoolStuffInc.com. We draw the Exquisite Blade. We'll discard nothing here. and I guess they're just dead. This sucks. They're just dead. So boring. Alright, so it's not got everything. Whatever. Tribe's not got everything, maybe. Scry one. Top card is... How about Time Walk on top? And I'll draw it with the thing. Let's play a splicer. Bottom it. Idol can block two. Yeah, whatever, sure. I know we're not, like, technically dead on board, but they're basically dead. Ooh, never mind. Shark Typhoon. Alright. Are they gonna kill my Oracle? Oh, don't you kill my Oracle. I can get it back. Never mind. I have Power Gun. Is Settle in this cube? If it is, I mean, they have no white mana, so. Alright, so they're gonna kill my Oracle and chump block. I could blink it too. Yeah, I'm just gonna get it back with Sarah Paragon, so. Sarah Paragon. Play Oracle. Shuffle Power 9 to my deck again. So now my deck is like literally half Power 9 at this point. Oh! Woo! Oh, we did it. We did it. We did the thing. Blink it again. More Power 9 in my deck. Yes! Our deck's gonna be so big. More Power 9 in my deck. I'm having a wonderful time. Our deck is 59 cards. The thing is that it's funny because Untapped doesn't know how to track that because, like, it doesn't add cards to decks, so it's like, you can't see, but, like, our deck right now is, like, ridiculous. Drunk with Power! Let's draw Mox Pearl? Sure! Let's draw all the Moxes. I, like, actually want them to Wrath now, so we can keep playing this game. Right now we have, like, 5 recalls and 5 Time Walks in our deck. Oh, I'm gonna, don't worry. We'll get an episode of Freshly Brewed in. You put this card in my cube? We could do that. I mean, like, conjuring cards is, like, perfectly doable on paper, you know? The thing is, I would need, like, 5 of each card, though, because, like, you would get, like, a few things you blink it. But, oh boy. Having a great time. Let's draw Twister next turn. And now drawing Twister is insane, because, like, we'll draw a Moxit and stuff, too, so... Discovery. All right, great. I don't think we're going to get in the turn here, unfortunately, but we Lotused. Hey, where'd the Lotus go? Did I, like, use the Lotus by accident or something? What did I do with the Lotus? We have Lotus Sarah Paragon. That's sick. What happened to the Lotus? Didn't I cast Lotus? I'm, like, not paying attention. Lotus got used on a unicorn trick. I wasn't even paying attention. We just used Lotus for one mana. All non-believers in chat gotta raise their hand in shame right now. Alright, this is fine. It's, like, not great, but it's fine. Lutri again? Why is Lutri in the cube? This is like a total free roll. Like, when do you ever not take Lutri, right? Alright. Blue white. Don't want to cast this as a 2/2. I don't think so. I'm gonna play this thing as a land. Whatever. Just like a. What's up, Zam? The tournament yesterday? What was yesterday? You mean the community gaming tournament? That was 2 days ago, right? Alright. Just say go. Our hands are very reactive, so. Figures of Flash, you can play them before you exile from Paragon. Yeah, probably. That's kind of fun. Thassa. Okay. Sure. I think we'll just Skyclave that. Like, I don't really care about the tokens, so I have the Deputy also, so I'm just not allowed them to start blinking stuff. Watch them do Lutri of Emanate. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. And Lutri's kind of lame. Like, it's an actual free roll. Lyra Dawnbringer. Sure. I mean, like, I guess we deputy? I think this card's going to be pretty bad for us because, like, nothing's ever going to die, but... Yeah, I guess. I don't love it, but... It's a big game, folks. We're 6-0. Playing for the undefeated streak. And the tears of the, damn it. The tears of the non-believers. This card sucks. All right, sure. So they get their thing back. I guess untap it, like, march it for a bunch. They have a protection spell, though. We might be in trouble. Sarah Paragon. All right. Let's say I just do this now, probably. All right, here we go. This has to work or we're in trouble. Cool. And then no trades these, we'll just say go. So now we have Paragon, the Unicorn, and Niambi. We have nothing in our bin just yet, but... And this ETB's copy an instant or sorcery you control. So like, what are they exactly? Like, they look a little blinky. Draw the Power 9 card next turn? I'm in. I'm here to have a good time, alright? Winning is just, you know, something else that I do also. But, alright, they are the actual blink deck. They have Teleportation Circle and Thassa. So they're going to blink Skyclave, give me a 3-3, and then exile my Skyclave. That's pretty awkward, actually. We don't have a good way to get rid of this circle, truth be told. And they're exiling all my... Who called it? They're going to give me an army of illusions, but... Alright, so I guess we just, like... And they're going to kill whatever I play with this, but... We just play... the Unicorn and play the Oracle. Sure. Lutrying Time Walk is pretty sweet. Alright, so Conjure Power 9, play the 4-4, just say go. Circle plus Skyclave is rough when I've already lost my Skyclave and my Deputy. Next four draw steps. Mox Jet, Mox Pearl, Mox Emerald, Island. Angel of Sanctions? Damn. They're doing it. But now they're really doing it. Yeah. Twister would be great, obviously, but... I mean... This is fine, I guess. It's pretty gross. The combination here of, like... Skyclave to kill something, and then Angel to blink the token. You just keep doing that over and over and over again. It's pretty disgusting. Alright, so they eat that. Okay. Now what? I still think we're, like, in huge trouble, because the problem is that, like, the cards we'd be drawing to beat these cards are both in exile. So, like, the problem is that all the exiling removal makes Sarah Paragon and Niambi, like, worthless. Like, blinking Oracle, like, isn't even good. I think we're just in pretty big doo-doo. We should, like, play this in Scry, I guess. Scry 2, Resto. Resto is like fine, but all right. And say, go. I think we're dead. We're dead this game. It's Cassian. Cassian. Cassian.
You're saying it wrong.
Cassian. It's Cassian. So they can just like blink Skyclave, eat one of these. Yada, yada, yada. Again, I'm just not sure how we're going to beat this setup. because our arbitral spells are gone. Play Emeria as a land untapped. That is no way that's good for us. Not a chance. Big trouble. If you haven't followed the stream, hit that follow button. Watching YouTube, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Take a second, follow me on all my other platforms: Instagram, TikTok, ChristianMingle.com, Twitter, YouTube, Bronson Mythic YouTube, etc. Hit those buttons, please. Support me. I got a kid. I got mouths to feed. Here come the shitters. I could like Niambi my Charming Prince back. Not that that does much. It only returns non-legendary creatures. Tandy! What's up, Todd? I am playing some cube draft on Arena. Welcome. Shout out to Todd. Obviously, Todd's great. A lot of big Pioneer. Todd, what should I play in the SCG this weekend in Pioneer? What should I play in the Regional Championship? Talk to me. Yes, like I could return one of these. It would re-trigger, but then I would shuffle. Anyway. Just take four, I guess. RC is new cards, Philly is old cards, yes. Is there anything busted in a new set? We're so dead. Just shocked it in, just didn't do anything with it? Oh, we're so dead. Super dead. Alright, so they get to hit my Oracle Tilt. Posting tons of brews. I don't need brews, I need good decks. Alright, brews are for streaming. Good decks are for tournaments. What's good? Shit. I mean, like, I guess Resto can block, I guess. Just say go. This sucks. Mono green. Mono green's lame. I got a ban Karn. They're gonna ban Karn, right? They're gonna ban something in mono green for sure. Ooh, that's fun. 8 Pyromancer with Of One Mind. I do like Of One Mind a lot. Card's sweet. On the clock. Come on, opponent. Let's just freaking go. Alright. What's up, Ghost King? How's it going, my friend? What platform do you use to play? This is Magic the Gathering Arena. It's free to download. It's a free-to-play game, but obviously if you want all cards you want, it costs a little more than that. So it's also Magic Online, too. Check them out. They're just going to play Lutri as a 3-2. Sure. The problem is we're just, like, pretty DOB here. So. We can, like. We're at 9. Sure. Go to 6. We can return the Charming Prince back. We can also Resto 2. Send step, resolve a circle. I should do nothing. Alright, so we'll play the Protector. Alright, you got me. Alright, we're not going undefeated. Alright, sorry, I couldn't do the 7-0. 6-1. Almost. Thanks, Krusty, appreciate it. Thanks for the resub. Do I use any keyboard hotkeys or Oni mouse? What? Keepin'. Hand is okay, it's not great, but. Oh, only mouse. I got some hotkeys. Some hottie keys. I kinda wanna just scry here. Nah, I'll put the thingy. I command over circle, sure. But I mean like we already lost the game, so Sadistic Pilgrim. Interesting. We draw a nightclub bouncer. I'm in. I like it. Charming to the last. Scry. Bottoms. That's a sick bottom right there. Ooh, we love a sick bottom. Woo! Leylance, I go. We got nightclub bouncer now. Two of his cards. The nit. Forsworn Paladin. Sure. Oracle of the Alpha. I like this card. Attack. Cathar Commando. Ah, crap. Fellow Chucker, eh? Time Twister, Time Twister, Time Twister. What's up, John Glass? Blocks, sure. Triggers. Alright, so Oracle conjures in our Power 9, which they go. It's in there somewhere. Achubaka. Alright, so this is like not that bad. Oh, that was a good draw. So we like don't want to bounce Chupacabra, obviously, or two drop really, all these bounce spells in my hand, but that was a great draw. I'm in. We splicing. Oh no. Freaking boat. Boat is disgusting. Alright. This sucks, because I can, like, bounce the boat. It's recast it, obviously. Ugh. No. So I can bounce, like, boat, Elias, and Splicer, and recast Splicer. Then they just, like, play the boat again and kill my 3-3, which is terrible for us, so. I guess we just say go. I mean, like, if they were to crew in, like, Bouncer Block, maybe, or something. Junji the Midnight Sky. Alright, that wasn't the worst. So now I get to crew. We're gonna bounce Sky Sovereign, I guess. Or no, maybe I just bounce Junji. I don't even know, honestly. We're pretty freaking screwed, honestly. Alright, so we play Bouncer, bounce Junji, block Chupacabra. Just not exactly sure what our path to victory is here. Especially at four life with this thing in play. It's not a plane, that's for sure. Oh man, we might be going off to the ultimate match here. The ultimate showdown, because we're just dead on board again. Shit. Yeah, alright. I guess I'll let him kill me, but... man! I'm talking mad smack about going undefeated, and now we're 6-3 playing for everything. All right, here it is, big match, folks. Cue your Guile theme. It's a big match, serious mode time. No talking. Keep hands all alchemy cards. Can't lose. Sarah Paragon. All right, let's go. Swamp. Welcoming Vampire. I'm going to hold this against a black deck. Mono Swamp Aggro. Okay. I'm going to Oracle. Shuffle in our Power 9. They're probably just going to kill it. Keep my Vampire safe. Give me that Power 9. Swamp. Mountain. Gonti. No, they're going to steal my Ancestral Recall. Oh, God, not like this. Please don't. All right, there's a Plains. Let's attack and leave up Bouncer or Niambi Cathar Commando. Scry one. Is that even good? Not really, right? It's like fine. So I can make two land drops next turn. So we're gonna go Sego, Cathar Commando, Block Gonti, End Step, Niambiat back. That's pretty good. And then next turn. Yeah, it doesn't really help. The mana doesn't really help us that much. I'm going to bottom it. All right, so. Definitely drawing Mox Jet next turn for sure. Attack, coward. Captain Lannery Storm. Wow. Alright. I guess I gotta kill that instead, right? Going commando. I guess the best case scenario here would be they kill us before blocks. Oh my god. Oh no, it's a march! They stole my march! That ruins everything. That actually ruins everything. Because they're exiling it. Everyone keeps exiling it and screwing me up. Alright. Shit. I guess it's fine. I'll just take it. I'll play Vampire and Niambi next turn. Sure. Drop Femoria too. Damn. Alright. Play this. We'll just say go. Actually, I'm attacking Scry, because I have a... I can't play a box anyway, so... Island. I don't think I want that. Alright, let's take up. Alright. Land 6. We got Paragon. God, the exiling effects are killing me right now. They're really killing me. I'm just going to cast this and draw a card. I'm not going to ephemerate the vampire. Just draw a card. Resto. Cool. Contempt that. This blocks this. We're at a healthy 13. Our hand's pretty stacked. Charming Prince. Okay. I kind of want to land now, honestly. Let's attack. I guess we're going to, like, Prince and dig. Yeah, all right. By Prince and I can't bounce her. I can't bounce this, though, obviously, so. And Prince is pretty bad here, actually. Maybe I just freaking Resto. Let's say go. Just Resto block Gonti. Look at that. 2 power 9s in the bottom of the deck. It's crazy talk. Just working our way to our recall. Do I blink the Oracle? I just have to, right? Even if I don't want to, I just have to do it. I can't not do it for the content, so. More power 9, please. And block. One time twister, please. Power 18. Woo! Do the math. All right, do it.
Can I kick it?
Opportunistic Dragon. When this endless battlefield is a human or artifact an opponent controls. All right, there's no human or artifact. Sure. Just a 4/3 flyer. Whatever. Nightclub Bouncer. Okay, sure. Brawl's Expertise. Alright, we just like Nightclub Bouncer this with Ephemerate up. It's pretty good. Just say go. It's funny, I wish I'd drawn that 6 land like pretty bad now, honestly, but... Bounce that, make it cost one more. Now it costs 5. It's a good card, honestly. Good draft card. I think this card saw a little bit of play in constructed. Like it's a 4/3 flyer, but like Chupacabra's a creature, you know? It's like not that bad. Soul Transfer? So obviously I can ephemerate this, but like I get no value off it at all. Why do they keep exiling my shit too? Why is everything exile? It's unbelievable. What do we think here? What do we think? Why would they do this and not just play the dragon again and try and steal it? Yeah, let's ephemerate it and get more power. Yeah, sure, whatever. I'll ephemerate it. I want this thing to be able to blink it. I want to blink this thing over and over again, so sure. And now I like can't play a creature. I can bounce their treasure too. That's sick. Here's your dragon. And they steal my bouncer. Ephemerate my thing for more power. Mox Jet. Love it. We could just like Brawls. I can Paragon for a Niambi now for a little value, but I can bounce my own Jet for value too. Let's go like one, two, three. And then we'll cast the cast Paragon. I can't really use it, you know, like I don't want it to just die, you know, but yeah, I can just play it. Whatever, sure. Play Paragon, play Mox. And then we'll play Charming Prince and we will Scry, I suppose. We could blank Oracle again, but like, all right, fine. I'll do it. I'll do it again. All right, you sold me on it. I can't resist. 59 card deck. Lelia. Ooh, Lelia's really good. We just block it though. I guess so. It's not that good. Wow. I mean, they hit a Moon Scion. We just block with everything, right? Just literally has to die no matter what, so. Yeah, my deck is more power 9 than my original starting deck list. Play this thing, and we draw a Black Lotus. And now I can cast Oracle of the Alphas on each of your turns, sure. Alright, give me a Lotus. How about some more power? Huh? Now you're playing with power. I could also have Black Lotus with Sarah Paragon too, which is kind of sick. Alright, let's look at this. Let me just say go. Doesn't it have a counter on it? Oh no, I'm thinking of the other card. Sure, whatever. And we'll just say go. I guess not the best stat. It doesn't actually matter. The power 45! Right, I'm thinking of Biting Bomb Ninja, correct. The Thoughtseize one. Oh, that's a card. And Robber of the Rich, okay. Sure. Yeah, I guess you're just gonna do this. This thing can't attack us, or it's bad for us, so. They're at 13. Draw Mox Emerald. Yeah, we're definitely gonna draw a lot of things. This is whenever a thing dies, so let's attack with everything, I guess. Then I'll replay this thing to block. I guess that's risky for... This is a human, too. Yeah, I guess I gotta leave one thing back here, I guess. To block the Scion. This back, actually. Let's just do this. So let's go attack like this. Scry. Mox Emerald, sure. This is the point where you really want to draw... the Twister, because like you just play all your lands also, because they're all boxing. All right, game's getting close. Play this. I'm gonna play this too. Whatever. So you go. One recall, please. Only got 5 of them there, so. Uh. When Gearlock enters the battlefield, target opponent may have you draw three cards. If the player doesn't, you mill three and take damage equal to the mana value of all those cards. Just draw three. I'm not dying here. Like, I don't know. What do you think, folks? They hit these three cards. I would take 11, and I'm at 13. 13's pretty close. I feel like, you know, like 11 or less, they just draw. I love Moxon. You're right, actually. No, I'm sorry. They mill, not me. They mill. They draw. If they just hit like some random six drop and then just kill me out of nowhere, that would be pretty embarrassing. But drawing three is also all right. We thinking no cowards here. I'm not a coward. They don't draw three. They mill three, and I might just die. All right, whatever. Let's do it. I'm no coward. No!
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Come on! They milled a 6 drop, a 5 drop, and a 2 drop for exactly lethal. That is absurdly unlikely. Come on! Who's...
Somebody's playing a prank on me!
I should have just been a coward. Alright, I guess we went from 6-0 to 6-3. I gotta pay Venom. I'm so sad right now. The sadness I feel is unbelievable. Anti-negative makes the resub. Oh my god. No.
Inconceivable!
I got a breeding pool. What did I get a breeding pool for? Oh, man. I'm so sad. I never got to cast Time Twisters. The problem was that we went 6-0 without ever drawing our stupid Black Lotus card. And then I started drawing that and losing. All right, that's okay. All right, YouTube folks, love you. Like, comment, subscribe. You're all great.